you gotta tell folks to sit down somewhere, to quit being a gate man. Amen. And these folk are trying to be a gate against God's man and against the people of God. And the Bible said around this time it was, amen, the day of Passover, and unleavened bread, which literally means a Jewish holiday of Passover. And the Bible says that when they had apprehended him, amen, they went to Peter and they went out looking for Peter, and they had killed other, amen, Jesus' brother and people and John's brother. They had killed these men for simply standing on the word of God. Man, you wonder, I'm just going to church. I'm just being saved as God want me to. I'm trying to live the way that God want me to, but we on some people's hit list because we decide to make Jesus our choice.
Go ahead, preacher.
Man, is somebody in here? You know, I went to Denny's one time and I ate the Super Bird sandwich. You know, on the picture, it looks so good. You go to McDonald's, you look at the Big Mac and you look at it. And the quarter pounder, and you say, that look good, but then when you get the package, it's a little burger about that big. There's something wrong with that. And it's the same thing in church, in Jesus Christ. When we joined church and we gave our life over to God, we said, I didn't know I was going to have to deal with all this mess. I didn't know I was going to have to deal with all these mean people. I didn't know I was going to have to be talked about and judged just because I'm a believer, just because I'm a child of God. Just because I want to go to church. I didn't sign up for this. I didn't order this. Amen. But I heard the Bible say many are the afflictions of the righteous, but they will overcome them all. The Bible said that they took Peter and delivered him, amen, in jail. And they put him in jail all because he was sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. And this gospel that we preach, and this gospel that we live, and this gospel that we exemplate, and then sometimes because we take a stand for the gospel, some folk hate us. Because we take a stand, amen, and say, for God's word is what I stand on. Some people have a problem with that. Amen. Because we decide to make Jesus our choice, because we decided to say, I am redeemed. I'm bought with a price. And we go through so much in our life. Amen. And then the Bible says that, amen, when they took Peter to jail, they took the rock. Peter was that outspoken one. Amen. Peter was always saying something with Jesus. You remember Peter. Amen. Always talking. Amen. And they took Peter's crazy self to jail because he was sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ. And the Bible said that the saints weren't just sitting around. And Pastor Ballard, I found out if I'm sick in the hospital, I don't need my church just to sit around. And I need somebody to pray for me. If I'm having a problem in my home, I don't need the church just to sit around and talk about me. But I need somebody to pray for me. I need somebody to restore me. I need somebody, amen, to help me along the way. Man, if I could just help somebody along the way, I found out my living is not in vain. But the Bible says that when Peter was taken to prison, amen, the Bible says that they kept him in prison. They put him in a whole bunch of chains, and they wrapped his feet in chains, and they wrapped his hand and his arms in chains, and they had the man of God in a spot where he couldn't quite get out of. Amen. I heard my pastor tell me one time, he said, son, what preaching will get you into, prayer will get you out of. And in some situations, as a child of God, we get ourselves in some situations. But I heard the Bible say, watch and pray. And we ought to all men, ought to always pray. And faint not. And it's too many folk fainting in the life. It's too many folk fainting in their walk. It's too many people falling out and perishing. But how many know you got power through prayer? And I found out the Bible says Peter, therefore, was kept in prison. Somebody shout, he was kept in prison. A lot of us, we are being kept in a prison mindset. We cannot release ourselves to the blessings of God all because, amen, our mind is not in a place where we can receive and do greater. But it's time for you. you to get unlocked out that jail cell tonight. Look at somebody and say, I'm coming out of that prison mindset. I'm coming out of that prison mentality. And the Bible said that they made prayer unto God for Peter. And the Bible says here that prayer literally means to worship God. And how many know they were not, amen, praying a sad prayer. They were not saying, Lord, Peter is in prison and we need no. But they were worshiping God. They said, we're going to praise God till Peter get out of there. And see, the thing about prayer, when you pray, you need to already be thanking God for what you need. Amen. Don't ask, but just thank him for it. Say, God, I thank you for my house. God, I thank you for that miracle. I thank you in advance for my healing. Because look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, it's already yours. Amen. Everything that you need, it's already yours. The Bible said that they tried to entrap Peter in prison. But the Bible said the saints, amen, is there any saints in the house that believe that God can answer prayer? Is there anybody in here that can say, I don't mind praying to God? Because every time I pray, I know God will answer my prayer. Amen. I heard the songwriter say, that problem that I had, I could not sing to Saul, but I turned it over to Jesus. I started praying about it. I turned it over to the Lord, and he will work it out. Is there anybody in here that can say tonight, I turned my situation over to Jesus, and he worked it out on my behalf? Is there anybody that ever had some bills due in your life? Is there anybody that's ever been sick and it felt like you couldn't get well? Remember, I dare you to turn it over to Jesus. And the Bible said that prayer was made without ceasing. And how many know as Christians of God, we ought to always pray? And we don't need to have a stingy prayer life. A lot of us have a stingy prayer life. But look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, you need to share your prayers. You need to pray for somebody. I heard Bishop Morton say, I'll pray for you, and you pray for me. And we're going to watch God change things. Is there anybody in here that says, I need to change my life? I need to change my walk. I need to change my talk. I need some changes in my life. And how many know God is calling for a praying church? I heard Christopher say that if my people were to call by my name, would humble itself and turn from their wicked ways. See, we got a lot of folk talking about folk. We got a lot of folk judging folk. We got a lot of folk saying, ooh, look what she got on. But God is calling for some people that are praying. Is there anybody in here that says, I'm going to pray when the weight of the world is on my shoulders? I wish I was able tonight. I'm going to pray. I'm going to turn it over to Jesus. Every problem that I have, I'm going to turn it over to Jesus. Because he can work it out. Yeah. Change comes. Amen. Thank you. Let's give God a hand of praise.